Bonjour tout le monde. Je suis très heureux d'être ici avec vous aujourd'hui. I'd like to first thank Prime Minister Kalyans. Thank you so much for your warm welcome. As well, we continue to strengthen the relationship between Canada and Latvia. Prime Minister Sanchez, Pedro, it's good to see you. I know how important the contribution of Spain is to the success of the mission here. NATO Secretary General Stoltenberg, thank you, Jens, for being with us today. It's extremely important. NATO truly is multinational. It was absolutely amazing to see the culminating military exercise of our troops from different nations, including those of Canada, Latvia, and Spain, training together. It was great to be here, and I'm also very happy to be joined today by Minister Anand, our Minister of National Defence, and the Chief of Defence Staff, General Eyre. We had a very productive day today. On top of my different bilateral meetings with Kristianis, Prime Minister Kyrens, Prime Minister Sanchez, and NATO Secretary General Stoltenberg, I also met with President Levits of Latvia to discuss Ukraine and a broad range of topics. In addition, this morning, Kristianis was able to organize that we were joined virtually by the Prime Minister of Estonia, Kaja Kallas, and the Prime Minister of Lithuania, Ingrida Šimonytė. We agreed to deepen the partnership between Canada and the Baltic countries, especially at this time of uncertainty. Ici au camp à Dazi, j'ai aussi eu la chance de rencontrer plusieurs membres des forces armées canadiennes et des autres pays de l'OTAN. Je les ai remerciés personnellement pour leur travail remarquable et leur professionnalisme. Last month, Canada announced the deployment of up to 460 members of the Canadian Armed Forces to NATO through Operation Reassurance. This announcement includes more troops here in Latvia, as well as the deployment of an additional frigate and maritime patrol aircraft. A total of 540 CAF personnel are now deployed here in Latvia, and approximately 130 more will join in the coming weeks. Well, today, I can further announce an early multi-year renewal of Operation Reassurance to support NATO in Central and Eastern Europe. This mission was set to expire next year, and in light of the situation in Europe, we decided to renew it ahead of schedule. Operation Reassurance is the CAF support to NATO's assurance and deterrence measures. The troops here are not only defending Latvia or Eastern Europe, they're defending all NATO allies, including Canada. They're defending our freedom and our security. That's why this work is so important, especially in the face of continued Russian aggression. Aujourd'hui, je peux annoncer que le Canada va renouveler l'opération Réassurance pour plusieurs années afin de soutenir l'OTAN, en particulier sur le flanc Est. On va continuer d'être là pour défendre la démocratie en Europe et partout dans le monde. Demain, je serai à Berlin, où je vais entre autres rencontrer le chancelier Scholz. Et merci encore à nos forces de nous accueillir aujourd'hui. Today, in particular, during International Women's Day, I want to thank all the brave women who serve in the Canadian Armed Forces for their outstanding work and all the women who serve in armed forces around the world. Canada will continue to be an ally and partner to help defend our shared values, and we will continue to be there for Ukraine